Добрый день, уважаемые участники, гости и профессорский преподавательский состав. Разрешите начать мой доклад на английском языке. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Let me introduce myself. My name is Diana Dushnyazova. I'm served here student of Faculty of Technology and Bioresources. Allow me to present my scientific topic entitled as Early Prediction of Milk Productivity by Using Genetic Markers. And subtopic of this big project is identification of gene polymorphism by using genetic markers in the locus of Kappa-casein, thyroglobulin, and growth hormone. As you know, in our country, animal husbandry is one of the leading branch of agricultural production, supplier of food for human and raw materials for industry. Dairy cattle breeding is one of the most important sectors of livestock, and we have to increase the milk productivity, and the fulfillment of this condition is quite possible in the design molecular methods and improve the breeding value of animals. In the Republic of Kazakhstan, needed reliable criteria for testing milk productivity. Recently, the selection work is actively searching for DNA markers can be used in the milk yield parameters. And the purpose of work is to study the frequency of genetic variants of lesser growth hormone. Next slide, please. And the problems and solutions of this work. Improving profitability of dairy cattle breeding is the first problem. The second problem is accelerating the pace of improvement of breeding and productive quality of animals necessitates an early methods and requires reliable, accurate forecasting techniques which would have a good repeatability and relatively high heritability. Objects of research for the blood samples was ATDT of Alataz cows breed, isolation of DNA from the blood of breeding animals, gene sequence analysis of BGRs, SSN3 and TGI as known as Kappa-casein, thyroglobulin and growth hormone. Solution of these problems is the incidence of growth hormone genes alleles be installed and Kappa-casein, thyroglobulin and BGRs. For the first time it will be set according to the prevalence of genetic variants, locus of cows of Alataz local breeds of domestic breeding. Next slide. A work on genotypic cows was held in the Educational Scientific Diagnostic Laboratory, Kazakh Japanese Innovation Center. I also did this project with our co-partner university, Agriculture University in Nitra. The second, next slide. Here you can see all of the steps of the isolation of DNA from blood samples by phenylchloroform method. You can see all the steps, like we took all the blood we're taking from the breeding farm Karpatas in the Jambul city, and we took like 1,000 microliters of blood and add 400 microliter samples of buffer. You can I will not read all of this. You can see all the steps. Next slide. What is this? It's a visual form of the phenylchloroform extraction protocol. Is also. And this is a primers for detection of all the alleles. Like for the first, the Kappa-casein alleles, we get it like literally from the scientific work of Dr. Medrano. What about primers for detection alleles of growth hormone and thyroglobulin? We get it like experimentally way. By, as you know, like NCBA base is a big base of genes, and also we have like primary online base. We also did all the primers we get from there. This table shows the condition for amplification for genotypic of animals. All the conditions for the PCR analysis we got experimentally way. The first step is like initial denaturation. It was only one cycle. Step number two is like three steps is like denaturation, annealing of primers and elongation. The most important action was annealing of primers because we need to set the right temperature for this. And the number of cycles in total was like 35. Also the important moment in this conditions is the concentration of magnesium chloride. Next. This table shows the composition of reaction mixture. It's also, I think it's not need to read it all, but the overall volume it was like 50, and but we divided by 6 to get more extracted DNA.
This is like the folder of the PCR analysis. You could see all the steps. As I said, we did only two cycles, and we got only 8 copies of DNA. As a result of this program, you could see all the electrophorogram of, this is electrophorogram of the growth hormone amplification, and as markers, we use the MCP1, and the length fragments, you could see like on the first row and the last row, it was like only 13 blood samples, and the first row showed like it was like 242 base pairs, and the last row as markers shows like 223, and it shows like it was only heterozygous genotype of GAS. The next is electrophorogram product restriction and gene amplification of growth hormone also, but the ended nucleus of restriction was LU1 and MCP1. On the top row you can see LU1, and the bottom row MCP1. Also you can see all of the numbers of base pairs.